the baler guys, they will, sometimes they will start at about 9 o'clock at night, bail into probably 2 or 3 in the morning. After they're done bailing, we will service, service the rakes, service the balers as far as greasing, any broken parts. The hay haul crew will come out here and start hauling the hay out, weigh it, and then it all starts over the next day.
There's a rhythm to life in agricultural communities like Dell City. After 2 decades, Daniel Nielsen should know.
It takes a big team to run a farm this big.
It's one bale of hay, but a lot of people's hard work. Daniel's and his dad, Arnold's. They work together on this farm.
Nothing's the same like it used to be. You know, a lot of farmers, or some of the old folks here, they used to be here, some of them are retiring, and some are not even doing much no more.
According to the Texas Water Development Board, Arnold is exactly right. In a 2008 state report, the number of acres of irrigated farmland in the Dell City area peaked in the late 1960s and early 70s. It's been in a steady decline ever since. But a new breed of farmers are questioning the old ways and building a more sustainable future for this valley and its water resources.
Being out here in Dell City is no different. All we're trying to do is figuring out the most sustainable way for us to make a profit, feed our families, and grow our community.
Jay Hill farms on land owned by El Paso Water near Dell City. The utility is a worldwide leader in water conservation. As a result, El Paso Water and its partners have a responsibility to bring that innovative spirit to the agricultural practices on lands owned by the utility. Jay and his team are reducing the number of acres of cropland they water with yesterday's inefficient flood irrigation. For generations, farmers pumped water out of the ground, transported it in canals like this one, and flooded their fields.
So this is the actual emitter.
Today, they've converted hundreds of acres of fields to underground drip irrigation systems. They've installed electronic sensors to curtail waste on quarter-mile-long irrigation pivots, and they're also using low-tech tools too, like planting companion crops to improve soil quality and help the ground retain more water. It saves water, meaning less is pumped out of the Bone Springs Victoria Peak Aquifer. But these sustainable farming practices also help preserve jobs for the community. And folks like Daniel are excited to be a part of it.
He's trying to bring new techniques to agriculture. And I think it's cool that he's not trying to stay with the same technique. The drip irrigation is something that the valley has never seen.
While many folks just whiz by on the highway between El Paso and Carlsbad,
Dell City is a lot like a diamond in the rough. It's very beautiful, peaceful. You have the highest peak in Texas just in your backyard.
Next time you pass the Dell City Junction, consider that there's something special happening in the Valley of Hidden Water.
They do a lot of cotton and chili. It's really special in here, you know.